Well, in this chapter, this lesson, we're going to be talking about analysis of variance. We're going to introduce you to the F statistic. So now, up to this point, you've learned about the Z, the T, and now we're going to introduce you to the F. Well, here's just a quick rundown of the Z, the T, and the F, and when to use it. And as we've talked before, we use the Z when we know the population standard deviation. We use the T when we're comparing means, and we don't know what the population standard deviation is. We're going to use the F to compare the variances of two samples or compare the means of three or more population groups. And that'll make more sense as we get going here. Well, as you can see here, the F still is used in hypothesis testing, and we're comparing variances. So when we're comparing variances, our null hypothesis would be that there is no difference in the variances, or the variances between sample 1 and sample 2 is equal. The alternative hypothesis would be that they're not equal. And as you can see from the formula given here, the way we compute the F is we just take the variance of sample 1 divided by the variance of sample 2, and that will give us the F statistic. Now remember, when we're working with two samples, we're comparing the variance, not the means, when we're working with the F. So with this example, we have a limousine company, and there's two routes that he can take driving to the airport. One is via US 25, the other is via Interstate 75. We have samples taken of how long it takes with each route, and what we want to know here is there a difference in the variation? In other words, is one of the routes more likely to be tied up with traffic? Does it take longer sometimes, shorter other times? And so what we're going to do, we're going to do hypothesis testing. We're going to use the 0.10 significance level and compute the F to see if there is indeed a difference in the variance between these two routes. Okay, so here we have the first three steps of hypothesis testing. The null hypothesis is that there is no difference in the variance between sample 1 and sample 2, or route 1 and route 2. The alternate hypothesis is that there is a difference. The significance level is 0.1, and we're going to use the F statistic because we're comparing the variance, not the mean. Because we are doing hypothesis testing, we need to determine our decision rule or determine a critical value. And to do that, we're going to use the F distribution table. We're going to have degrees of freedom in the numerator and degrees of freedom in the denominator. And so for the degrees of freedom in the numerator, when we're working with two samples comparing the variances, the degrees of freedom in the numerator is N1, sample size 1 minus 1, and for the denominator, it is sample size of 2 minus 1. So in this case, we use the 6 and 7 column. We find a critical value with the 0.05 distribution level being 3.87. Now, notice that we're using the 0.05 significance level. That's because this is actually a two-tail test, and so we're going to divide that in 2. So we take the 0.1 divided by 2, and we end up with the alpha of 0.05 on either side or either tail. You might remember from the previous slide, computing the F statistic is actually very easy. It's just the variance of sample 1 divided by the variance of sample 2. So the next step is to actually compute the standard deviations, and then from there we can get the variance. And you can see on this slide it's done manually. I would much rather prefer to use Excel, which we'll see that in the next slide. But if you prefer to compute it manually, remember it's simply the sum of the squared differences divided by n minus 1. And of course that gives you the variance. You take the square root of that, and you'll have the standard deviation. Now this is how I would prefer to compute the standard deviation. It's just to use the standard deviation function in Excel. Notice we're using the .s function to compute the standard deviation. That's because these are samples rather than populations. Well, here we are. We're actually computing the F statistic, and notice that we take the standard deviations and square them. That's because we're actually converting them back to variances. So the F statistic is the variance for sample 1 divided by the variance of sample 2. We then come up with a computed F of 4.23. We're then going to compare that to the critical value that we looked up a few minutes ago. And when we're deciding whether to reject or not reject the null hypothesis, the rules are still the same. We compare the critical value to the statistic that we computed. So our critical value was 3.866. The F statistic that we computed was 4.23. So that is outside the do not reject area. So in other words, this is in the reject area. So we reject the null hypothesis and therefore conclude that there is a difference in the variation of those two routes. Well, as you might have guessed, Excel can actually do this directly with the data analysis feature. And the selection that you would choose in data analysis is Ftest to sample for variances. You just highlight range 1 and range 2, and you see in this slide the result that you get. You get the mean, the variances, the degrees of freedoms. You also get the critical value, the 3.87 showing up there, as well as the computed F, the 4.23. So again, using Excel's data analysis does give you some additional features and really can save you some time. Now in the previous slides we saw how to use the F statistic to compare the variances of two samples. We can also use it if we're going to compare the means of three or more samples. All right, when we're doing hypothesis testing with the analysis of variance, we're assuming the null hypothesis is that the population means are all the same, are all equal. The alternate hypothesis is that at least one of them is different from the others. So the test statistic would be the F, and so the hypothesis would be set up as follows. The null hypothesis is that the mean of population 1 is equal to the mean of population 2, and so on and so forth. And so the alternate is that the means are not equal, at least one of them is different. The degrees of freedom in the numerator are going to be k, which is the number of samples that you have, not the number within the samples, but the number of samples. The degrees of freedom in the denominator are going to be n minus k, and n is the total number of observations. Well, here you have the formula for computing the F statistic when you're working with three or more populations or samples. You have the F statistic computed as the sum of the squared differences for treatment divided by K minus 1 divided by SSE, which is the sum of the squared differences attributed to error divided by N minus K. Well, don't get hung up on this too much, because if you've already guessed, there's going to be an Excel function that's going to do this very easily. We'll go ahead and step you through how to compute it manually, just so you know, but we'll also show you how to do it in Excel. So here's an example to see how we can actually compute the F statistic when we're working with four different samples. So we have four airlines. Each of these were given satisfaction surveys, and we want to know if there is a difference in the means between Northern, WTA, Ponco, and Branson satisfaction survey means. Well, here we go through the five-step hypothesis testing process. So step number one is to state the null and the alternate hypothesis. The null hypothesis is that all of the satisfaction survey means are equal. The alternate is that they are not equal. So we're going to use the 0.01 significance level for the problem. All right, step three was to figure out what test statistic we're going to use, and because we're comparing the means of more than two groups, we're going to use the F. Then we have to find the critical value. So the parameters for the critical value, the significance level is 0.01. The degrees of freedom for the numerator are k minus 1. Remember, there were four airlines, so 4 minus 1 is 3 for the numerator. There were a total of 22 observations, so we have n minus k, or 22 minus 4, 18 for the denominator. Once we have the level of significance, 0.01, we know that there are 3 degrees of freedom in the numerator and 18 degrees of freedom in the denominator. We end up with a critical F value of 5.09. So the next step is to actually compute it and compare what we get to the critical value. What you're looking at right now is an ANOVA table, and the ANOVA table shows us the SST, the source of variation for treatments, the SSE, the variation is error. We also see an SS total. We see how then to compute the F, which is the MST divided by the MSE. We see how to compute the mean square for treatment, the mean square for error. And if you're interested in computing this manually, the book will take you through it. It's not impossible to do. There are quite a few calculations that you have to do in figuring out the SST and the SSE, but we're just going to show you how to do it in Excel, or at least introduce it to you in the next slide. After you go through the manual computation of this a few times, you'll really appreciate doing it in Excel. As you can see, it's very easily done in Excel. You use the data analysis, ANOVA single factor. You just select the observations, and it will then give you an ANOVA table, and you see an example of that on this slide. I do want to point out a couple of things, though, that Excel labels the SST between groups, and it labels the SSE within groups. So if you see between groups, within groups, that's exactly what the book refers to as SST and SSE. You can also see in the ANOVA table, it displays the critical F value, which we looked up a minute ago, which was the 5.09. It then gives us the computed F, which is 8.991. So, looking at this, we compare the F statistic that we computed to the F critical value, and it is larger, so therefore we are going to reject the null hypothesis. We will assume in this case that at least one of those means is different from the rest.